Hello teachers, myself Jyotirmay. I am going to guide you how to teach each and every student as per their learning styles. So today I have taken a topic of class 10, which is reflection and refraction. So it's a very important topic. So let's go through it, and on the process I'll be guiding you how to train the students as per the learning styles. So if it's a visual student, then mind maps or the flowchart diagrams plays a very important role while teaching. So here you see, I have created a diagram or a flowchart. Mirrors are of two types, plane mirror and the spherical mirror. So we know what is a plane mirror. Plane mirror means a particular mirror which is actually plane at its surface. So whenever we talk about a mirror, mirror is basically any object which is actually shiny part has got in it. So whenever a light comes onto it, it reflects. When you talk of a spherical mirror means a mirror that has been obtained from a part as they are the part of a sphere. So it has got two types, one is called the concave mirror, another is the convex mirror. So what I am following here is a flowchart diagram. Concave mirror looks like this and the convex mirror looks like this. So in this part it is shiny, in this part this is, we can say, sorry, in this part this is shiny. I just erase it to make it clear. Yeah. Okay, so this is concave mirror and the convex mirror. To the way forward, I will be explaining the children with a video representation. Okay, the properties of the image formed by the concave mirror. You know, we have got the positions of the object, position of the image and the size of the image and the nature of the image. There are different types of cases we are going to study about it in the video. So let us understand what is going to happen. So in this case, it is a plane mirror. Here we have got the object. An object has been kept in front of the plane mirror. So you see the ray diagram, it comes from here to here. And another from here, so it reflects it, so you can get this image out here. So in this case the image form is a virtual one because it is in the other side of the mirror. Now let's talk about the concave mirror cases. At the infinity, at the infinity means the position of the object has been at the infinity, which is very far away from the center of the curvature. Now let us understand the ray diagram. The ray diagrams can be taken. So object, you can see the object has been kept at the infinity. So you see the two ray, parallel ray diagrams, rays is coming out. So these rays are hitting this particular concave mirror. Whenever there is a parallel beam of light, it's coming to hitting the concave mirror, it is going to pass through the focus or the focal point. So the image location is going to be at the focus, image at the focus. Highly diminished point size and real and inverted. Why it is real? Because you can cast this particular image on a particular screen. So this is very important. So this is the location of the image. Once again, in the blue line, you can see how it is happening. If you have been given with a case in which, you know, the ray of diagram, ray of line is coming to you at a parallel ray of line. So you can see if it's passed through the center of curvature, it goes out of the center of curvature. If it goes through the focus, it will be parallel. And ultimately, the image you're going to get is at the focus. So image, object placed at infinity, image location at the focus. So now beyond C, that is in between infinity and center of curvature, but it is much closer to center of curvature now. So you can see we have taken up the length of it, 10 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 100 centimeter, what should be it? So let us find it by a ray diagram. So you can see as the object has been placed out here, it is in between, as you see, it has been placed beyond C. So let us check out this one. You will see a ray diagram would be coming out from this particular object. So this is the object, as you can see, this is the object. Please have a focus on this particular one. Yeah. So now you see the ray diagram, which is parallel to the principal axis, and a ray diagram that is ray, which is passing through the focus. So where should be the image? As I already told you, a ray of light which is actually parallel to principal axis is going to pass through the focus, and the ray diagram, which actually is passing through the focus, is be parallel to the principal axis again. So your image is going to be right here. So now you see, you can see once again the blue light coming out, have a focus on it. You can find out where you can find the image. You can find the image where this both of these lines are cutting, you know, this is the point where you're going to get the image of this particular object. As you can see, it's quite visible to you. Yeah. So like for example, if it's from the foot of this particular object, then it's going to be simply the parallel line, simply line that should be through the principal axis. So you now this got the image. So how is the image? It's quite visible that the image is inverted, it is diminished, and it is even real, because of the fact that it is not forming the other side of the mirror. You can get this particular mirror on a screen. So this is once again, you can see it repeatedly. You can see this is the image which has been formed out here. Okay, fine. So now this particular topic, I am going to explain it for a kinesthetic learner. Now, who is a kinesthetic learner? I have explained it for a visual learner. Now, for the kinesthetic learner, same topic for the kinesthetic learner, but it is in the mode of an experimental video, which I'm going to show to you. So you see how the image, you have been keeping this particular candle in the infinity, that is infinity. So you can find where the image has been formed. Image has been formed on the focus. So object is at very far infinity. I have kept in this infinity. So the object formed at the focus, nature, real, inverted image, you can find out as per the ray diagram rules and protocols. So now object has been kept at beyond C. So image would be formed between F and C. As you can see in the dark room also, this experiment, you can find out the image to be formed in between F and C. So image is formed between focus and the center of curvature in this particular case. If it's clear to you, so case number two, object beyond C, the ray diagram, you can see that was the experiment and the ray diagram, nature, real and inverted image, and it has been developed. So case number three, the object at center of curvature. So object has been kept at the center of curvature now. So image to be formed at the C only, which you can find out, image has been formed at the C only. In the dark room, you can find the image much more clearly. It has been formed here, which is image has been formed at the center of curvature. If it's clear to you, case number three, you can find it in the ray diagram. How it's, you have been kept it out here, so you get the image at the center of curvature, real, inverted, and the most important part, it's of the same, you know, it could be enlarged inside. Okay, now you see about the object which has been kept at the focus. If it's been object kept at the focus, image is formed very far at the infinity. So you can see the screen has been kept far apart. You can find this is, you know, the screen, or in the screen you're getting the image. It's highly enlarged. It's a highly enlarged one, and you get the image at the infinity. So this is how it happens. In the case number five, if you can go through the ray diagram, you have object kept in the focus. You can see the image, which is actually real, inverted, and highly enlarged object in between P and F. So when the object is kept in P and F, this is the only case in which you are going to get a virtual image, because of the fact that no image, only reflected light patch you can find. So you see the image is in front of this particular screen. So virtual image can be seen inside the mirror. So this was the practical experiment which shows your RAIN topic for a visual learner and a kinesthetic learner. Now for the auditory learner, how the auditory learner going to deal with? Auditory learner are the people who loves to listen to the lecture more, there is hand expressions of the teachers more, and the right, so normal way of teaching in which we would be adding a little bit of music to the delivery, that would be done in the editing part. So I'm going to explain you the same topic, same way in the form two, in case of So this is the pre-written one, the case 1, case 2, case 3, case 5 has been given out here. So object placed at infinity, object located beyond the center of curvature. So you see, the slide is going to represent this thing as everything. You see, even see it. So the way the object is in between infinity and the center of curvature, the properties of the image is diminished, it's real and inverse. So you can see the image that has been formed here. It's a straightforward ray diagram which is going we're going to explain here through the diagrammatic. So you can see out here, it's passing through the F, it's parallel. If it's passing through the center of curvature, it's coming back and you're getting the image right here. So this is quite the conventional method of teaching which we will be using for the auditory mode of learners, and I hope it has been clear to you. In this simple video, I have explained how to teach a topic for as per the visual learner, as per the kinesthetic learner, as well as for the auditory learners. Thank you very much for your time.